Students, in this activity, you will learn about the different parts of a flower. For this, here I took a flower. Its name is hibiscus, which is red in color. It can be seen easily in our surroundings. It is very common flower. With the help of this flower, you will learn about the male and female parts of the flower and its sepals and petals. For this, first of all, we will dissect its first part, which is green in color. As you see, it is the first part of the flower, and its function is to protect the flower when it is in bud form. When we dissect it and see it carefully and count its parts, it is five in number. You can count 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So this is first part of the flower, which is green in color, and its function is to protect the flower when it is in bud form. Now we will see its second part, which is red in color. It is of different colors in different flowers. It can be yellow, white, pink, any color. It is colorful to attract the insects for pollination. As we count its petals, these are 5 in color. These are also 5 in number. Now we separate these petals from the flower very carefully. When we separate these petals, then we get its inner part, which contains male and female part of the flower. This structure contains male and female parts of the flower. In this, the lower part, which is green in color, and this tube-like structure, which is pollen tube, and its upper part is pollen tubes. Upper part contains thread-like structures. These are called filaments, and these consist of anthers. The yellowish structure on the filament is known as anthers, and these anthers contain pollen grains, which are powdery. This is the male part of the flower, and this is also called androecium. In this flower, both male and female parts are present. Now we will see its female part by dissecting it very carefully. As we cut it with a knife, you will see there is a thread-like structure which starts from the lower part and joins to the upper part. This is style. This is female part. At the base, it joins to the ovary, and at the tip, it joins to the stigma. As you see, this is a thread-like structure. This is its female part. As you see, I dissect it very carefully to show you the upper part of the flower, that is stigma. This is stigma. All the three parts you can see here, stigma, style, and this is ovary. Ovary contains ovules. And after pollination, this ovary changes to fruit and ovules changes to seeds. This is called the female part of the flower and also known as gynoecium. So you have learned female part has three structures, ovary, style and stigma, and male part have filament and anthers, and anthers contain pollen grains. Male part is called endosium and female part is called gynoecium. So a flower has four parts: petals, sepals, and androecium and gynoecium, that is male and female part of the flower. Now you will learn this with the help of this chart. Here, as you see, this is green in color. These are called sepals, which are colorful. These are called petals. These are colorful for pollination, and third part is male part, that is called androecium. It has a filament and anthers, and anthers contains pollen grains. This yellowish color structure, as you see, these are anthers. These contain pollen grains. And this is the female part of the flower, which is called gynoecium. In Hindi, it is called Istri Kesar. This part also have three parts. This is ovary, which contain ovules. This is style, and its upper part is called stigma, which is sticky. This structure help in pollination of the flower. So you have enjoyed this.